8 correct vision habits. This is the normal function of the eye's visual system, including the brain and the body. You practice these and you'll be imitating normal eye, brain, body function. After a while, you won't have to practice. They'll just occur on their own. The eyes and entire visual system will return back to normal function, and clear vision will occur automatically. So here we go. Number one, relaxation. Usually people that have unclear vision have tension in their mind, in their neck, in their eye muscles, and this impairs the function of the brain with the eyes, the brain with the nerves that go into the eyes and the eye muscles and the retina, the lens, all parts of the eye. When you relax, the eye muscles relax, they move the eye freely, nice and easy, so that healthy, normal eye shifting occurs, which brings clear vision. When the brain and eyes are relaxed, eye muscles are relaxed, the brain works with the eyes and the retina perfectly. Left and right hemispheres are synchronized, working together. The visual cortex, all parts of the brain work correct with the eyes. The neck muscles also relax. Neck muscle tension, limited movement in the neck, is a main cause of muscle tension that resonates up into the eyes. Makes that eye go out of shape a little bit, puts a little pressure on the lens, makes the vision unclear because it goofs up the focus of the light rays in the eyes. When you relax the mind, your body, the neck, positive thinking, positive thoughts, the eye muscles relax. The eye returns the normal round shape and vision is clear. That also improves the function of the lens, every part of the eye. So how do you obtain relaxation? Let's see. I like this guy, Robert Monroe. He sells tapes. He's got a lot of books you can read free in the libraries. You can see his address here. Robert Monroe, the Monroe Institute. MonroeInstitute.org. He has many videos on his website. He's located in, I think, Virginia, Faber, Virginia. You can check it out on the website. He has a school there where you can go and take a class, learn relaxation, left and right brain hemisphere activation and integration. A lot of people who practice this, they say it improves their vision. So let's see, we don't have too much time on YouTube today, so we'll go to another one here. You can practice palming. That's a Bates method, natural eyesight improvement relaxation technique, activity. We've shown this in our other videos. He sits, relaxes, puts a pillow on his lap so he doesn't have any tension holding his arms up. And he covers his closed eyes with the palms of his hands. And you can go to cleareyesight.info and copy and paste this picture, because there's a certain way you're supposed to put your hands. Right eye, right hand, left eye, left hand, and they're crisscrossed a certain way. That also activates and integrates the left and right brain hemispheres. And he just imagines something pleasant in his mind. You can imagine a scenery like this. And in his mind, say there's a river flowing through here, and he sees it moving and the sun sparkling on the river. Maybe some yellow flowers are here. He'll shift on the object. He'll shift on a tree in his mind. He'll just move throughout the field, and he can imagine anything he wants. He can imagine an apple tree here, and a bee lands on an apple, walks around, then he flies around to one of the flowers throughout the scenery. Imagine anything you want, a leaf blowing through the air. Maybe somebody in a boat on the river floating down with a fishing pole in the water. Whatever you like, imagine that. and imagine an action, motion, just like real life movie, in color, and imagine it clear. Nice and easy, imagine everything clear, and imagine shifting on objects and seeing fine details clear with no effort at all. And you'll notice that your physical eyes will move even when you're just imagining this. You can also use the color chart. You start in beta, that's wide awake, and you work your way imagining different colors as you do deep, relaxed abdominal breathing. Imagine your body is filled and surrounded with sparkling red. Then you imagine sparkling white, then orange, and you go all the way through. There's a specific way to do it with the breathing. You can read it on here for free. You get to purple, light purple, you're in alpha brainwave state. That's very relaxed. From there, you can go on to theta, borderline of awake asleep, in delta, into deep dreamless sleep. And you can learn how to program your mind with one of these numbers to bring you into a relaxation state instantly throughout the day whenever you need relaxation. And there's a lot of other ways to get relaxation. You can read it on the website, speak to other natural vision improvement teachers. Number two, blinking. Blink your eyes. Improves the tear production, keeps the vision clear. When you blink, your eyes shift automatically. You don't want to overdo blinking. You don't want to, but you just notice if you're staring and not blinking, and try to remind yourself, blink and relax. Breathing, abdominal breathing. A lot of people breathe through only their upper chest. Chest rises, nothing rises down here, just the chest. All these muscles get tense. Breathing becomes shallow, more muscle tension, less oxygen to the eyes, muscle tension in the neck. You learn to do abdominal breathing. Diaphragmic, breathe from your diaphragm. Your stomach goes out first when you breathe in. Then the chest rises, stomach rises more. Stomach rises and diaphragm rise first on the inward breath. Then the chest, then out, chest down, stomach down. You can get a free breathing lesson just by watching a baby. Watch how the baby's stomach goes up and down when he breathes. He doesn't have any tension up in his chest. He's nice and relaxed. Breathe in, stomach goes up. Breathe down, stomach goes down. Yawn. Yawning stretches and relaxes all the muscles in the neck, the head. That resonates into the eyes. You can stretch. Like you see a cat stretch when he yawns. Improves the flow of lymph in your body. Makes natural tears. That's good for your eyes. Shifting, number four. Look at an object, shift part to part. Shift on smaller parts. You use your nose feather and trace along the edges. Shift on a smaller object. Shift point to point on a small part of an object. Number five, central fixation. Here's the center of the visual field. This is the part you see with. This is the part that moves on the object. See the dots in the center? That's clearer than 20/20 with the brightest color. That dot moves on the apple. From every place you see the dot is where the center of the visual field moves as the eyes move. So it moves here, it's in the center. That's clearest. Moves here, that's clearest. Moves here, now that's clearest. Moves here, now that's clearest. Just move that center of your visual field on the object you want to see. Blink and relax. Out here is the peripheral, it's less clear. Here is the center, clearest. Movement. When you move, your muscles are healthy, they're relaxed, you get some exercise. Movement also pertains when you want to look at something, you turn and you face it. Your eyes, your head, and your body turn and face the object. If you spent all day at the computer looking out of the side of your face with your head in the opposite direction, you'll get a stiff neck. So just, when you want to look at something, turn and face it. You can turn to the side, you know, sometimes without turning the whole body. But if you really want to look at something, you know, when you're working or you continue talking to someone, continue looking at something, turn the whole body and face it. You'll notice you'll have much less tension. You won't have any tension in your muscles when you do it that way. When you face the object you're looking at. Oppositional movement, that's on our, I'll let you look at that on our website. You can type that in on our search bar. We also have a chapter on it. So I don't want to run out of time on this video. Basically, you can do the long swing or the sway, and you notice when you move one direction, objects in the visual field move the opposite. Then you move to the left, objects move to the right. Move to the right, objects move to the left. You can get to the point where you can just move the eyes, shifting left and right on a tiny, tiny object, and still notice that oppositional movement. It's very relaxing for the eyes. And when you can see that, you can move up and down to any direction. See the object you're looking at move in the opposite direction the eyes, head, face move to. Your vision becomes clear. Shift, blink. Memory and imagination. We covered that earlier in the palming. You can palm, or you can keep your eyes open. Just imagine something you enjoy. Whenever you use your imagination, imagine objects clear, in color, motion. Imagine using your correct vision habits. You can practice with your eyes closed, palming, or not palming, just daydreaming with the eyes closed, or open. Whatever you think, the thoughts in your mind are accompanied by pictures. That's how the brain works. So when you see that picture, imagine it clear. Look at details on the pictures in your imagination. And think something happy. When you think something happy, your mind relaxes, your eyes relax, and your memory and imagination improve. And vision is clear. Practice looking at something at a close distance every day. Shift point to point. Small part to small part. Read your fine print. Switching, number 8. This is just basically behavioral optometry. Practice looking at shifting on close objects, middle objects, distant, back and forth, back and forth. Both eyes together, one eye at a time. Both eyes together again, a little more. With an eye, if one eye has less clear vision, practice a little longer with that to get the vision equally clear in both eyes. This is also switching close, middle, and far. She's got 3 pencils lined up with each other in perfect alignment. This helps shift on this one, then shift on the far, then back to this one, back to the far. Same thing, both eyes, one at a time, both eyes. Remember to shift when you look at something. Don't stare. Shift part to part. Point to point. This improves her convergence, divergence, accommodation, unaccommodation, binocular vision, fusion, 3D vision. That's about it. Get your sunlight daily. The most important, the eyes evolve. The human eye, all animals' eyes, they evolved because of the sun. They evolved under the sun. In the sunlight. So get out there and get some sun every day. You'll be seeing clearer. Okie dokie.